I feel like I'm reading for someone that is single, a single Cancer, focusing on their well-being, money, values, powering up, self-empowerment, connecting to the divine. I feel like your last situation ended and it was justice. It was the judgment call for it to end. Because there were secrets. Secret, maybe someone was returning to their past person. Here you are now as the High Priestess. I feel like you're studying or contemplating internally your soul, your spirit, because you want to experience love. But you're asking the divine what's going on. Like inside of yourself, even quietly, you're asking, you know, I want to sort this energy out. What's going on inside of me that I'm not, that will make, that I'm not attracting the love that I want? So you're studying. You're also releasing, okay, to make way for the new. You want to heal and restore something deep within you. You're not really talking about it, but it's happening emotionally, clearing up. And the divine is definitely working with you. Okay? I feel like you're going to see this transformation physically. So, because it is taking place emotionally, emotional restoration. Just because you want to heal. You know, you start asking questions. You start to want the better feelings. You start to invite them in. This Page of Pentacles is my turn your burdens to light vibration. It's like alchemy, turning your burdens to light, transmuting energy. I think that's what you're doing a lot of now internally. And you know, the work has begun. I feel like you started to get some clarity emotionally. You know, and it starts to bring in balance for you, good feelings, knowing more of what you want. I feel like you're realizing that the past also was here to teach you, to help you to know about what you want, even the parts that weren't such nice experiences. And that clarity is bringing in stability emotionally and materially. Now, Cancer, with the Justice card here for you, I'm feeling like everything is working in your favor because of your heart, your higher intelligence, your divine connection to the divine. You know, this High Priestess card, if I share a story with you, I don't know if you will believe me, but there was, when I was younger, I had this dream, you know, and this, when I learned about tarot. Last year, I had this dream when I was younger that I was on this wall, and there were many of us, and I was almost like I was in a picture frame. I couldn't move, but I was kind of arguing with a female below me in another picture frame. It's kind of incredible. I always wonder what the heck kind of dream was that, and I felt like we were Asian people. I was like, what? But I know I was in a fuss with the female below me. Because I was, and I couldn't move, I can't even tell you, it's so amazing. But anyway, I kind of brushed that dream. I have many weird kind of dreams like that. I brushed that to the side, you know, I thought about it every now and then. But after I started doing tarot last year, I was observing this High Priestess. Just kind of feeling out the card, and I literally felt like she was alive. I swear. So I feel like these characters on these cards are alive. It's like how I felt in my dream. I was alive. I was on this platform like this now. And I felt I came to life. But I had this quarrel with this female below me. That was the main part of the dream. Is that I had a quarrel with this other painting. But I wasn't even thinking we were painting. I just couldn't understand what that was about. Anyhow. So I want you to imagine that these people are alive. These are just paintings on a card, but they're magical, and I feel they could move. Anyway, so I feel like that's how powerfully you connect to what is divine. You are a part of the thread of all the magical things. So that's the justice, is that. That's how I feel. That's how protected I feel you are. You are a part of some amazing things. So maybe your dreams have been telling you this. But anywho, justice is here to protect you. And it caused this. I feel justice is really what caused this separation. Justice wants to also give you the sword, or to tell you that you have the sword to sever a tie. And the same connection that you were previously in, it's not completely severed. So justice is kind of upset because this person is tagging along in your energy, and they're kind of holding you back, really, sort of energetically, in the way you feel and think of yourself. They're just all up in your space. You thought you'd gotten far from this person, but they're literally right there energetically. Justice wants you to go into this space, maybe meditation, or get into the energy in thought. The sword's energy, thoughts, action, declaration, speaking, power. And to sever this person from tagging along, it's like you just pick up a, you picked up a person, a thing that just got attached to you. Okay? And they're determined, and justice don't like that. You know, because I feel you have work to do. That's why I'm saying you are so connected to the divine. You have so much to do that justice wants you to go into meditation or in a space, maybe even in a hypnotic state, and find where this person is still connected to you and sever that now. Because you got work to do. I feel you really developed some feelings for this person. Strong. Like this person injected themselves in you. This person could be feeding off of your blood like a parasite, or off of your energy still. But you need to cut that supply now. I'm just showing you. Look at Justice's face.
It's not playing.
It's giving you the sword to sever this connection so that you can move into more fruitful things. Moving from the 5 to the 7 of Pentacles. You just need to move forward. And there's prosperity coming up. Changes, right? Changes. And when I say change, I feel money and I feel transformation. It just means changes for all of this sense of the word. Changes for you. Behind that, we have the Magician. So it's beautiful transformation because this Magician energy feels well. I think the Magician is the one that could want to help the Empress to realize who she is. It's the energy of waking up and realizing where you are, like in that dream I felt where I was on this picture frame, but now I'm saying it's tarot cards. And all, like maybe someone just wants you to wake up, like shouting at you, hey, wake up, you're in this. Because all along you've been played instead of playing. So the Magician is here to shake up this change. This person may have been keeping you, whoops, in the 3D. You know what I mean? They kept you in the 3D. This person is also afraid of moving forward. So they want you staying with them in the 3D. They don't want your spirit to leave so that you awaken to who you are. You know what I mean? It's the energy of going in the matrix. And then there's this person there with you. They want you to stay. They don't want you to wake up to the truth of who you are. And your energy, you've maybe fallen in love with this person or something, and you don't want to leave. I feel you're also sleeping, like you're under a trance. Like this person, Magician, this person, I feel like they've been using some energy, the things they wear, things they keep around them. They may wear something around their neck. Listen, this person has a bell around his neck. this could be an agent. What is the word? Agent. This person could be an agent. An agent trying to keep you here in the matrix, you know what I mean? And that's why the fuck Justice is so upset. He knows this. These people are your friends. The Justice, they are the major arcanas. That's what I'm about to tell you. You're a major arcana. You're a major player. You know what I mean? And so there are others. You need to wake up. I told you this yesterday too. I'm telling you, that dream I had with this woman, I woke up on a card. And I mean, I had this dream since I was, when I was a teenager or even younger. I've been having strange dreams. I wish I could share them all with you. You know, I've been dreaming about drones before drones existed. And we thought, in my dream as a child, I thought they were monsters in the sky. So this is how dreams work. That's why I am the High Priestess. And many of you are too. You have the gift of vision. So you need to wake up so that you can see what's true. See, like, imagine one of these people waking up and realizing that they're on a board. You know, they can hear me. I know it sounds crazy, but it's like that kind of waking up. Not being played, not sleeping, but realizing where you are. That's what Justice wants. That's why I'm talking about this so much, because that's Justice. They want me to tell you to sever this connection that's keeping you asleep. In the 3D, this person, that's what they're here for. They act like they need your help. Oh, I'm so broken down. I'm so tethered to the world. I'm so battered. You know what I mean? And that's how they pull at your heartstrings, because they know you're the Queen of Cups. They know you're the Cups energy. You want to love and heal. But this, they would drain your energy for all. But you're going to wake up. So, yeah, you are, because, see, we have the Three of Cups. That's a celebration, the ending, celebrating an ending or a new beginning. You know, after a union, after souls uniting, this is the energy that comes from that good feelings. Maybe with three people. But I just want you to know, and this is when you wake up. This feels like waking up. So it's important that you take that sword from Justice. It's like, no, you have the right and the will, the determination to sever this connection so you can come into the balance. And that balance is what? The Two of Pentacles. So your emotions and your material well-being is coming into balance. So it moves you into these changes, multiplication of changes, of income, of good feelings. Of feeling alive. This is the spirit of waking up. Something bursting of prosperity. The yawning. Stretching. You know what I mean? Look. The Fool. So you're about to arise. It's like being born again. Not knowing where you're going. Not knowing what you're going to see. But just like a child just fresh out of the womb. Opening your eyes to the world afore you. Okay, and you come with such a beautiful spirit, like you already have a life planned. You don't know what it is, you know, but you feel like, wow, I already have a life planned ahead of me. It's the energy of a baby genius that's coming into the world ready. You're like, whoa, this is life. Yes, that's the energy of waking up to who you are, High Priestess. Oh my goodness. I also had a dream where those Japanese movies where they run on bamboo trees, and when they jump in the air, they stay up there for hours. I had a dream I was one of those characters fighting in this desert place, and I was running across. I was so young, but in my mind, I was like, how the heck? And it's not one of those dreams where, you know, you just remember it from a movie. It's like the dream I had with waking up on a flat thing, and I couldn't move, and I'm like, what am I? And I was dressed in literally with thing. I felt I was Japanese. That's how I was interpreting it. Because that's why I had these long garments all over me. But then I kind of peeked to see the other cards below me. And there was this woman below me wearing the same kind of garments. But we had an argument. But I don't know why. I don't know why we were arguing, you know. But there are other people there. Maybe it's the magician energy too. Maybe we were arguing over this magician. I don't know. Possibly. But I don't know if we were arguing. But I know I had... It was contention, really, with this one. With the other female. Anywho. So you're going to take this leap of faith to move forward. And as you move forward, you move into Queen of Cups position. So you take your place, your rightful throne, so on and so forth. See what I mean? But while you're here, you're also, you know, even though it ended and you figured out how to receive love, because I feel like I just told you. Because remember in the beginning I said you're wanting to clear out some energy so that you can receive. And how you do that? It's to cut the tie with that person. So you need to cut the energetic tie. And now you're here. I feel you're ready, so to speak. You look like ready, like for that love that you want. But you're also focused up on something else. The ninja vibration. I told you. You need to just... I want you to know how awesome you are. Okay. They also focused upon your well-being and your money and your kingdom and all these things, your vision, your goal, your even like running your own kingdom, what you want to do in earth, in life, in your own community. You want to write books, you want to travel, you know. So although you want to experience love in your relationship and you want your energy to be ready for the best love, which is what you're ready for as Queen of Cups, you're also a visionary. And I feel you're about to do wonderful things on earth. So don't forget your dreams as well as your love, your heart, your emotions, the parts of you that you know you want to share. You know that. You know, so it's, and I feel the only reason why you may hold back from sharing that is because this past energy still lingers. And justice wants you to cut that. Yeah, there's much work to do. The things that you went through in the past, you're not supposed to just let go of them. You're going to use them to make a change. It has something to do with spirituality, religion, marriage, traditions, home, community, you know, teaching, being a leader, a healer. The Hierophant. So we're talking about the Hierophant vibration. The High Priestess and the Hierophant. That's like an ultimate union. The Seven of Swords, making its way, standing up, knowing you have the strength. The card represents valor, energy, exerting energy, work, creativity, things in progress, things growing. This also represents beating the odds. There's someone or something, maybe old friends coming back around to you, or friends of your friend. Of your old friend. You see this energy that you just like, I really need you to sever it energetically. And if you don't want to face it, just start working on you. You have much work to do. Much work to do. You didn't just come here. So as I say, you're focused on your healing. You want to clear the energies because you're wondering, listen, I want to know why I'm not experiencing love and money and the well-being lifestyle. And you get the answer. So, apply the knowledge, and then you're going to see the changes, okay? All right, much love. Hit the like button. Cancer, I'm going to do another reading for you. This has been your love money reading, basically. Just general messages for you that will give you insight on your journey. So if they resonate with you, do share the videos with those you love. Hit share and share to your groups and subscribe if you have not already done so. I really do appreciate you. I'll see you in the next one. Remember that you're all and all is within you. Bye.